In this video, I'll demonstrate how to use deep learning algorithms with Hikrobot embedded solutions, specifically smart cameras. A smart camera is a highly integrated compact machine vision system that combines image acquisition, storage, processing, and communication functions into a single device. These cameras are ideal for building cost-effective and robust machine vision project solutions. The ability to utilize deep learning algorithms further enhances their versatility across various applications. Let's start by focusing on the compatible products. For now, the SC3000 series and SC6000 series devices are the primary options. All of these smart cameras support character recognition based on deep learning algorithm, image classification, and object detection. Additionally, the SC6000 series supports instance segmentation algorithm. Each algorithm has its applicability area, of course. In this video, object detection will be used as an example, but general approach would be almost the same for any of the mentioned algorithms. For our demo, we'll use the MV-SC3013XC-08M-WBN vision sensor, a compact yet powerful device. Now it's time to talk about required instruments and environment. To train a deep learning model, we'll use the VisionTrain software, version 2.2. Pay attention to the build number, as subtle yet significant differences can exist between builds. I won't go into the installation process here. It's straightforward, and we've covered it in another video. Training will be performed locally, so a compatible graphics card is required. A GPU with at least 6 GB of memory is recommended, although GPU with smaller memory size can still handle training with limitations. Sometimes GPU driver version may become an issue. The newest driver doesn't always turn out to be the best one. Another important consideration is the trained model format. By default, VisionTrain produces models that are not directly compatible with SC-series devices, requiring additional conversion. This conversion can be done either in the cloud or locally. For the cloud conversion, it is necessary to submit trained model and training image set. While convenient for small datasets or low-resolution images, it may not be ideal for larger datasets or high-resolution images due to bandwidth constraints. Local conversion requires deployment of Windows subsystem for Linux and containerized Linux environment. Be prepared to allocate up to 50 GB of hard disk space. Additional patch has to be installed for the VisionTrain, and when all the components are deployed, it would be necessary to change this setting in VisionTrain configuration. Once this setup is complete, VisionTrain can locally produce deep learning models fully compatible with SC series devices. We will explore cloud conversion option in a few minutes. To interact with the smart camera, we will use the SCMVS application, version 2.4.2. This software supports camera setup, project configuration, and operation monitoring. Camera configuration with SCMVS won't be covered here, as it is explained in other videos available at Hikrobot website. For capturing training images, you can use FTP, save them locally, on the PC running SCMVS, or store them remotely on the camera. Remote image saving can be configured in the project settings under the output section. It is highly recommended to capture training images using the same camera intended for production use under identical lighting conditions. Ensuring high image quality and thorough annotation of the dataset is essential for achieving a high-performing model. Avoid using lossy compression formats such as JPEG for training images. Instead, opt for lossless formats like BMP or PNG to preserve image quality. Another important consideration is the number of images. Since we have two object categories, and the objects have well-defined shapes with minimal variation, it should be sufficient to capture around 10 to 15 images for each object type. Additionally, it's advisable to include a few images of the background without any objects for better model performance. With the training images collected, let's store them in a single folder. Now, it's time to create a project in the VisionTrain software. It is essential to select the right project type. Once the project is created, the next step is to import images and begin labeling. You can import all images at once by selecting the folder where they are stored. You will need to create a label for each object category in your set. VisionTrain provides several labeling tools. Experiment to find the tool that works best for your specific case. You can use filters in the left menu to view images by category, and the stats panel on the right can provide useful insights. Keep in mind that images are never permanently deleted from the dataset. They are only marked as removed. If an image is deleted, it cannot be re-added under the same name. Intelligent segmentation tool works only when the Vision Master license is available. Make sure to label all the images in the dataset. When labeling is complete, it's time to start training. First, choose a folder to save the trained model, and be sure to use a short path with no special characters. Note that the selected folder will be cleared before the model is saved, so ensure it doesn't contain any important files. Select the appropriate target platform and device series. Next, adjust the training parameters as needed. Use a higher resolution if the labeling objects are small, to retain critical features. If your objects have an orientation property and you need this output, enable the corresponding setting. It is disabled by default. For advanced settings, you can adjust the batch size based on your GPU memory or set it to be automatic. Keep in mind that model trained for smart camera target platform cannot be tested and evaluated by VisionTrain. And even if it could, Vision Master license with access to deep learning functions is required to perform model testing. Therefore, the model will be evaluated after deployment to the camera, and it doesn't make sense to reserve test images out of your training set. Start the training process and monitor its progress. Upon completion, you will either have a model ready for use or one that requires additional conversion, depending on your VisionTrain configuration. If you opted for cloud conversion, visit the AI training platform service using this URL. Registration is straightforward and only requires email confirmation. After logging in, you need to create model conversion task. Package the training set data into a single zip file and upload it along with the model. Once uploaded, initiate the conversion process. The converted model will be available for download upon completion.
Nice thing about the object detection algorithm is the ability to output the number of detected objects besides their type, also providing object coordinates and bounding boxes, should any subsequent processing be needed.
Now that the model is ready, let's upload it to the camera. You can use the same as CMVS project you previously used to collect images, but this time add a deep learning assisted object detection tool. Upload the trained model and configure other parameters, such as minimum detection confidence, check type, and more. For validation, object count will be used as a criterion to determine whether the check passes. With all preparations complete, let's observe the model's performance. As you can see, detection is stable, and no false positives occur even when other objects enter the camera's field of view. The project can also be configured to output object types, coordinates, and other properties via supported communication channels if needed. Thank you for your attention.